I'm okay with the car and I'm pretty well.
Hi, I'm Anish Chandran. I'm driving a BMW X1. This is the 20i. That's the petrol model. Right now, I'm getting 9 kilometers to a liter. When I had gone on the expressway, it was showing 11 on the reading. But otherwise, in my petrol empty refill that I do, I'm getting 9 every single time. So I'm hoping it gets better. Probably post 2,000-2,500 kilometers, it gets much better. I'm expecting somewhere close to maybe 11 in city and a little better outside. This, what I'm talking about, is a mixed bag of, you know, going into sports, going into eco pro. On a good day, driving well, you could get up to 5 kilometers more using the eco pro. So this is an eco pro right now. This is the driving style analysis. You can see it shows you distance to empty and it shows you how much extra you can get by driving the car in eco pro. So right now we've just started, so it's zero, and as we drive along you'll find how everything that comes over here in place of zero is extra distance that you're getting because of using eco pro. And it will give you stars over here. If you anticipate a breaker, you take your leg off the accelerator much before you let it coast. You can see now it's just starting to build up and I'm getting about 0.1 more. But as we just keep continuing down, you'll slowly see that it goes up to almost 5 kilometers extra. These cars typically have your first service after a year. I have gone in for the service package. So with that, what happens is all the maintenance with service cost is covered. Your oil, your labor, every single thing is covered in your BS. That's the schedule part of it. So anything that you need during your service is all done and covered. So you don't pay anything for it. So that also adds 1 year of extra warranty. So I think all of these cars typically come with 2 years of warranty. I paid close to 1,78,000 for the package. With your warranty, your BSI and your insurance, which even covers your logo, I think you're kind of fully covered and ready to take on whatever comes with these cars. In this segment, it's very typical of everybody to go and take a look at the Q3 and also the GLA, because it's all in the same price bracket and they're all say SUVs or small SUVs or crossovers. In terms of GLA, it's quite a stylish car, I'd say. It's quite a nice looking car, but very low on space and not that great on power also. Feel like a hatchback on stills. It wasn't really spacious inside, so I didn't really like that. It's quite dark and dingy. Even though it's got the sunroof, it's still not helping. Though the GLA is slotted in an SUV level, but it's not really there. It's more like a stylish hatch. Q3 was on my mind for a long time. The Q3's handling is not that great. The steering is very, very light. It feels almost like a toy car. It was not that high on style and performance. The general feel of the car is not really a punchy one, you know. It's more of a sedate kind of a car that you'd want to go to work and come back, or maybe a quiet getaway. Not something that you can have fun with. The older Q3 is now almost phased out. You have the new one coming in. I went in for test drive for all these cars, that I should be able to enjoy the drive and I should feel something different. And when I did my test drive, I made sure that I had all of them in the same day, so that, you know, I have the drive experience from the other car carried forward to when I come to the next car. This is a diverse car, so when I drove this, I could really feel that, and there's a connect when you drive. In terms of driver comfort, this car is really a 515, because this is a driver's car. You can see the whole dash here is a little tilted towards the driver. Everything is angled towards the driver. You can see these paddle shifters that you have here. These are not your plastic shifters, these are aluminium shifters, you know. Very nice. You can feel a little click there when you go driving. So this cowl over here that you can see has been placed down quite low and it's made slim. So you find that the visibility outside is very nice. You know, you have a good unobstructed view. Also, being a driver, it's got so much of glass area inside that you can see all over. You can actually see out very comfortably. When getting in and out, has been very comfortable. At the same time, you don't have to climb into the car or you don't have to get down into this car. You can actually slide in. This bolstering is a little extra that you normally see than the other cars. They would normally be a little wider. This one kind of really keeps you in place around corners and bends, you know. So it's very snug. I'm sitting very comfortably. I've heard a lot of people talk about the BMW X1 being a little difficult in getting out because you don't have space for your thighs touching your steering at times. So a lot of people have the under thigh support set up a little bit. For taller people, they could have a little bit of a problem, but then you can drop it down a little bit and then maybe, you know, you'd have a little bit more support there. You've had your old piano style pedal here and not your typical pedal sticking for the top for the acceleration. So this is also very comfortable to rest your heel down and use it. If you look at the back seat, you can find that it is really, really spacious. There's a lot of space all over. You can recline the seats. Space-wise, it's quite spacious. I think it's got one of the largest boot in this whole segment. This is a 500 liter boot. Almost all BMWs and Mercedes, they come with no spare wheel. And people spend extra and get a spare wheel and, you know, put it in their boot. It takes off a lot of space. But this was the first Beemer that actually gave you a spare wheel inside. So these are Hankook. These are 17-inch wheels. These are smaller than your standard wheel that you have. So you're not supposed to use this for too long. People sometimes just put it and forget it. This is for you to make sure that you are not using your regular wheels and you need to get that changed. Because the car is designed with their tires as stock in mind. So if you change anything, if you take out these run flats and put in normal tubeless, then it could affect probably the suspension, its performance, a whole lot of things. Some of these cars mark it with a bright orange rim so that you know that, you know, you are using the wrong wheel. You do feel a little rumble inside, you know, and it isn't the most plush ride that you would get. So the outside of this car, I like to call it very typical BMW with your normal kidney grill, and these are your high beams and low beams. These are complete LED lamps setup. The throw is really good and nice. Illumination is excellent. These are adaptive lights that they call it, that if you have ambient light, it's quite bright. They will have a diffuse throw, you know, it will be spread out. But if you go into a darker lane or something, you'd have the throw directed forward. The section inside here that you see, it's a dummy. But just to complete that pattern, they have this light here. This concept of the two DRLs, they call it angel light. This small little light in the corner here that you can see, a small shape, that is your turning lamps. When you're turning into a corner in the night, these will light up. You have this on a lot of cars nowadays, other models, but what they do is, irrespective of whichever side you turn in, both will come on. But with these, it's very specific about only which side that you turn. You have your fog lamps, these are halogen bulbs.
Do you like weather
lamps? I think it's nice and chunky, and it has that SUV feel to it. At the same time, it's interesting the way the tail lamps have been putting, you know, it's quite interesting to see. It's the more interesting end of the car. It looks nice. The roof rails also do come with this car. Externally, it would be about 4 out of 5. Fitted finish, I'm really happy with the way it is put together. It's got soft touch materials everywhere. New oyster color makes it much more airier and roomy. I'd rate it a 4.5 and 5. Steering is absolutely spot on, because it's not too heavy, it's not too light. This is absolutely spot on. It takes you where you need. It's got good control when you're going around corners or when you're driving hard. The compromise that you have to make is the drive quality. As in, compared to the other cars, by itself, it's very smooth. You wouldn't feel when you drive, you wouldn't realize when you drive. But I think when you compare to the Mercedes and you compare to the Q3, I think it's on a stiffer side. A lot of tire rush in the cabin, you know, so that is, I think, one of the negatives to do with this car. It's got 6 airbags. You have your front 2 airbags, you have your curtain airbags on the side and also in the rear, and it goes all the way back. In terms of braking, it's got a lot of assist, a lot of features. You've got something known as the brake assist. So when you're driving hard, or you know, you've suddenly seen a breaker, or you know, somebody come in front and then you put your foot on the brake. So when the car senses that you're doing an emergency brake or you're braking hard, you don't need to physically put your foot down and press hard. The car will do the rest for you. It will apply the rest of the brake for you. So once you've applied sufficient pressure, you don't have to go on. The car will do the rest for you. So you can feel the brake getting pulled in when you brake hard. So that's a brake assist for you. When you're driving and you're turning or you're cornering or you've got a slippery road, it can brake individual wheels depending on how much slip it detects. Safety would again be 4.5. I would have liked, you know, knee airbag. The build quality inside is quite good. Sheet metal, I'm not very sure about how strong, but I've looked at the crash test and it's got a 5-star rating, so I'm sure that they've done their job there. But in terms of internal plastic, you can see the quality is all good. No panel gaps, everything is put together, good finish. So this again would be, say, 4.5 and 5. But the value for money, I think it actually is bang on the buck, because every rupee you spend on this car, you've there's something that it's giving you back for. This driving part of it, the comfort, you know, the everything that you have inside is really value for money. Even the sound, the way the car sounds from inside, is quite good. So, yeah, definitely good value for money. Touchscreen, it's got the typical BMW iDrive. You can see the screen resolution. It's almost as good as the iPhone. Sharp, even in these bright sun conditions, you can see that it is really bright. You can use the iDrive, the shortcut buttons around it, any of these, the iDrive itself. I think by far the easiest media controls, the iDrive that you have on the BMW. These right here are your media controls, your radio, phone, USB, and these are shortcut keys that you can program. Okay. So I have set this to select the interior light. A nice ambient lighting going on here. So I have set my shortcut keys to choose interior mode. This has also got brake regeneration, so every time you use the brake, you've got this blue mark here that's lit up. As you can see, charge is the brake, the battery getting charged, and power here say is how much of power you're using. The BMW has got a speed limiter for you. So if you're probably driving down a road where you have a speed limit of say 70 or 80, you don't have to be looking down at the meter the whole time. Set the speed, switch this on, the light will come here. You can choose what speed you want to set it at over here. Now it's at 40, you can increase that up to maybe say 80. Drive, it won't go more than that speed. BMWs use run flat tires, that is if you have a puncture, you can still run with that.
How many kilometers does it go?
I think it starts from 80 kilometers, then you have different specifications. If you're just alone in the car and you have nobody else, at a speed of about 80, you could do almost 150 kilometers, depending on the road conditions. So you've got a whole lot of factors that you have to take in. You've got your Apple CarPlay, so you can, you know, use it to call for any song when you're driving. You don't need to go through your playlist. Voice activated, you can ask, I mean, I have my iPhone connected, so you can, you know, call out to Siri and get anything that you need when you're driving. It will read out SMSs to you, it read out WhatsApp messages. You can also connect your phone GPS along with the in-car navigation system. So everything that you need is displayed right here. A lot of the information also comes in here. This is typically what the Apple CarPlay looks like. You basically have your phone over here and your messages, your maps, you can access. So you've got the choice of using your Google Maps, you can use your iPhone Maps, or you can use navigation which is on the system.
Is it real-time?
Yeah, this is all real-time right now. So you can use this navigation. I think Google makes more sense because, you know, you can type in finer point, lanes and other things. This is quite generic in the way it works. You have something known as profiles. So not only is your seat setting, but your keys have profiles. So now that I have set all the shortcut keys and I have set the screen, everything to my liking. So every time I walk in with my key, it comes up with my settings. So when I bring in my key, it's all of my settings. So when my wife comes in with hers and she's got the way she would like it, so it's configured in, you know, to her style. This right here is to open the shade for the sunroof.
That's also automatic.
That's automatic, so the shade will go all the way back. I'm pushing it forward now. Okay. It's one touch and you have the shades coming all the way. That's one. The center little patch that you can see over here, a little round circle here in the center, that's to just open the roof a little for ventilation. Start stop button. This is a part of your fuel saving options that I mentioned.
Yeah.
So every time you come to a signal or you have stopped for more than a certain time or you brake hard, the car will stop itself and it will save fuel. The minute you touch anything, the steering, your accelerator, the brake or your gear, the car will start. And it is so seamless, you would never know the difference, the transition that you have stopped or you have started. So when you're driving, you would see that. You would never know that we have stopped and it would just start up again and you'd never even know that has happened. But it's also intelligent, as in, if you've set the AC at a particular temperature and it's not attained that temperature, it will not cut off. It won't stop the car. It's standard dual zone that you have. You have your co-passenger and your driver dual zone. So you can have this at one temperature and the other. Or you could just sync them both together. and you know, auto would set the temperature that you want. Like right now I put it at 16. It's also got a max 80 button. It's like for these kind of conditions, when you walk into a car that's really hot, you don't have to go fiddling, just press max AC. It maxes out everything, blower, temperature, everything. So it tries to give you the fastest cooling possible. It's got an activated charcoal filter. Here what you can see, this lever right here, it's your normal button that you can choose between external circulation or internal circulation. So you have something known as manual, where you now put it on the internal circulation. This is external circulation, and by using auto, I'm using the inbuilt charcoal filter to sense if there's too much dust outside. It will automatically, you know, switch it off. So that's an auto function for it. You've got these automatic dimming mirrors, the in-cabin and also the driver side. So at night, you never have much glare hitting you because they dim in automatically. You have a hill hold, so when you're at a slope, you can just press the brake, take your leg off the brake and the car stays. So it won't roll down till you put your leg back on the accelerator. These are dynamic grid lines. They turn when you are moving as per your steering inputs. The green lines are basically the edges of the car. So you can, you know, basically have an idea where your car is going to fit in. Red is for you to estimate or anticipate as to where your car will be turning into. If you want to go this way, this would be the pattern that the car would draw. And this would be the pattern if you were going the other way, as to where the car would finally end up. It's also got a sensor there. It gets different colors when you get closer to obstacles. The screen stays on after reverse for a few seconds to still show you what's happening in the back. That glass over there, the side view mirror on the passenger side, when I shift it into reverse, will dip down for you so that it shows you the curb when you're reversing. It goes back to your memory setting for your seat the minute you put it back there. You have now a typical BMW gear shifter. So you have park, one touch puts the car into park. Only for park, the rest of the things you have to put your leg on the brake, and then you can just one tap to shift. Or one tap to shift back, or you could just hold it to send it all the way to reverse.
This MSN, that's the manual in sport.
That's the manual in sport, so you just have to tap it into that. Now it's in your manual mode, it's in sport, you can read S1. From here on, tapping the same lever forward or in the back activates your manual mode. So you could choose to do it from here, or you could choose to just I think a shifter is much more easy. All the four windows are anti-pinch, including your sunroof. So if you have somebody's arm come in, that will bounce back from there.
This is a six-speaker setup.
Okay.
And you have the bass under the front seats.
Okay.
So it sounds...
your microphone. If you like this review, please subscribe to this channel and don't forget to press the bell icon and also give it a like. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Such a pleasure.